Guys, we're here with another video for another Intel processor launch. So this is the 18-core, 36-threaded Core i9-9980 Extreme Edition CPU, and it's gonna set you back $2,000. Let's be honest, this thing is geared towards a very specific niche, so let's cut to the chase and discuss why exactly this exists in the current state of the market right after this.
Hello, I'm looking for some fans.
Well, are you married?
Yeah, I have a ring.
What is your favorite number?
I would say 3.
Do I have the perfect fan for you?
This is the new Thermaltake Ring Trio 12 fans with good static pressure for radiators. It is a beautiful frame with double side and center ring illumination with soft and super bright spill with Razer Chroma compatibility. Control it through your smartphone, the RGB Plus software on the PC, or Amazon Alexa.
Well, I'm gonna take these home. Perhaps you should too. Check them out in the description below.
All right, so first things first, don't start thinking that these new 9000 series names with these new high-end CPUs means a completely new architecture, because they're not. In fact, Intel is still using the same underlying 14-nanometer Skylake-X design, because there hasn't been any significant changes from when those CPUs were launched more than a year ago. As a matter of fact, Intel is calling these new CPUs products formerly known as Skylake, instead of giving them a new name. Now, right away, you can see that the i9-9980XE, 9960X, and the 9940X will be direct replacements for the older generation. They come with some frequency increases, optimizations to cache, and soldered TIM that's supposed to lower temperatures. Oh, and they have exactly the same prices. I do have to mention that Intel has revised turbo management on these CPUs. They're now able to hit higher sustained clocks for longer periods of time, particularly when all cores are used. That's one of the reasons why the 9980XE base clock has increased by 400 MHz. Just note that the maximum turbo 3.0 rate has only increased by 100 MHz across the board. Looking at the 9920X, and things start to get interesting. It has more smart cache and also offers a huge 600 MHz base clock boost versus the 7920X. But those increases come at a cost of higher power consumption. Pricing remains at $1,200, and guys, that's still really expensive when you figure the AMD 2950X goes for around $900. When we start looking at the other new Skylake-X processors, there's some weird stuff happening with specifications and pricing, but I think that's to make sure that Intel's 9900K has some room. The 9900X keeps the 7900X's $1,000 price, but it gets a ton more cache and a bit higher clock speeds. Now, the 9820X is a really odd CPU, and I have to wonder why it's even around. It has the same 10-core layout as the 9900X, but it has lower clock speeds and costs just $100 less. Sure, it doesn't offer a lot more than the 7820X, and it actually has 44 CPU PCI lanes, but what's the use of this processor? I just don't get it. The additional PCI capability, cores, and cache are awesome, but that price is just way too high. As usual, Intel dangles a carrot in front of you and then hits you with a stick. I actually think the 9800X is the 7820X's real replacement, since it also goes for around $600. But with the 9900K around on a less expensive platform, the only benefit I see here would be running full-speed dual GPU solutions. Alright guys, so you now know what the whole new lineup is all about, but I have to be a bit critical on how Intel is approaching this launch. You see, they sent us this, you know, $2,000 18-core monstrosity instead of sending us the lower-tier variants within the refreshed Skylake-X lineup, because I feel like those CPUs are a little bit more interesting to me personally, considering that they're still overpriced. When you compare to what AMD samples us, they sent us everything from the 32-core all the way down to the 12-core variants, so that it gives us a full picture on what AMD is offering for their price. And it seems like Intel solely wants us to focus on their super expensive flagship component, and I think that's a huge mistake, because it gives its whole lineup an overpriced feel. Now, we might actually end up buying those other CPUs for more in-depth testing, but it just would have been nice to have the full picture right at launch. Now, before I get into the benchmarks, I want to explain some of the results you're about to see here. We first noticed some odd performance, since the 9980XE wasn't hitting Intel's stated frequencies, but after updating the Intel IME and Turbo 3.0 drivers, the system behaved like we expected. Let's start with the 9980XE during a long Blender test. Basically, it's hitting a pretty constant 3.8 GHz, and remember, the base clock here is supposed to be 3 GHz, but there's extra thermal headroom since the Noctua NHU14S kept temperatures below 75 degrees Celsius. That meant Intel's turbo technology could bump frequencies while it tried to hit maximum power input. It's pretty cool stuff. Now moving on to Prime 95, and the results here are very different from Blender. Here, the CPU was still around 75 degrees Celsius, but it also just hit 3.3 GHz. That's because Prime also stressed the cache and memory controllers instead of focusing on just the CPU cores and FPU units like Blender. This causes the CPU package to hit its power limit, so even though there's thermal headroom, clock speeds are lower. I also ran a quick single core test, and you can see that the Turbo Boost 3.0 is working exactly as advertised, with clocks at about 4.5 GHz pretty often. So that's what's happening behind the scenes, guys, and I know a lot of you guys in our previous video mentioned that you wanted to see the full setup, so here it is. Now, as you're watching or as you're going through these benchmarks, I do want to mention that other than the non-stock memory speeds, we made sure to turn off all motherboard enhancements during all these tests. So there you guys have it, and I have to say the performance increases on the 9980XE over the 7980XE can be impressive in the right circumstances. Now the issue is that the improvements are a bit narrowly focused on multi-core enhancements, so this could potentially be beneficial for professionals who would like to take advantage of, you know, who'd like the most amount of cores at the higher clock speeds. But you know, for things like gaming and photo editing, it's just pretty much impossible for me to recommend the 9980XE or just any Skylake-X CPUs at the moment. You're actually much better off investing in a Coffee Lake CPU or even a second generation Ryzen processor. The other issue with the 9980XE is that it seems to operate without even acknowledging the 2950X. Now I get it, that processor has four less threads, but it's $1,100 less. I'll repeat that, it's $1,100 cheaper. But for those professionals who need every ounce of multi-thread performance to save time on renderings or increase productivity, the 9980XE may be beneficial. But then again, there's also the 32-core Threadripper 2990WX, which also costs less than this thing. And what about power consumption? Well, this CPU is a hungry boy, since Intel's 14-nanometer process is having some issues keeping up with AMD's 12-nanometer technology. 344 watts is a lot of juice, guys. And the last thing that I want to mention here is pricing, because these Intel CPUs rarely hit the price that they give us right before launch. And the blame for that can obviously be shared between the retailers and Intel. But it's funny how AMD's products, you know, the pricing remains consistent with both reviews and retailers. So, you know, I'm just saying. So that's pretty much it, guys. And I just want to leave you guys with a little preview on where our journey with this processor will go next.